I'm Pat Cox. I have worked as an economist in what is now the University of Limerick. I worked as a broadcaster in RTE, president of the Liberal Group, president of the Parliament, but progressively and currently the strong concentration is on the theme of sustainability and fighting climate change. There are many large crises that the globe faces today, but one of the ones we know completely about is the global warming effect of greenhouse gases. We know what is the scale of the problem. We have a lot of the capacity in terms of policy and technology to bring solutions. And so I think there is an imperative to address this as a matter of ethics, as well as a matter of, I think, real opportunity and good economics. I think it's great that the government has brought forward its climate bill. It's not so great that in the early year or two of this new and heightened commitment to do things, that in fact we're still going backwards. A critical issue for our country is to move from verbalisation of policy into actual implementation of policy and achievement of key performance indicators.
Supernode's an ambitious technology company. We were founded just about 4 years ago now by Eddie O'Connor, and we're developing game-changing transmission technology based around superconductivity, which is applicable to renewables connection and transmission of large bulk power across Europe.
The technological challenge here is to develop this for a marine environment where we see a huge growth in the need for and the delivery of offshore wind systems. Yes, for Ireland, but not only. This is a global proposition, and so Supernode is developing a core technology that will allow us to develop supergrids.
We're building a superconducting cable technology, so it's absolutely a new system. Superconductors are magic materials, they're amazing materials. When they're cooled down to a certain temperature, they have absolutely no electrical resistance, which means we can make cables that are very power dense or very energy dense, or with a very small or an equivalent footprint, we can transmit almost an unlimited amount of current or an unlimited amount of power through them.
The peak demand in Europe is in its centre, so we need some kind of a super grid system connecting the periphery to itself and to the centre in order to address intermittency. The wind isn't always blowing everywhere all the time, but it's blowing somewhere all the time. And if you connect those up through a super grid, you're adding a capacity that doesn't exist today to meet tomorrow's needs, in which electricity will have a profound and important growing role.
So you'll have heard some of the targets announced, 30 gigawatts of offshore wind for Ireland, up to 70 gigawatts of offshore wind for Ireland. That's more than we can actually use in Ireland in terms of our renewables.
I think this technology can be an enabler of a lot more offshore wind development. That's a very costly proposition, but the money will be there because there's a return to be made from it. We think there is an enormous potential in this. It has a global potential, but in an Irish context, we could be a kind of Saudi Arabia of offshore wind. But to be that, we've got to move from verbalising the possibility to implementing and delivering.
Ultimately, we expect to be commercial with our technology towards the end of the decade, 2029, 2030, around that. And we have more interim milestones that we're well on course to meet. The most significant of those is to meet a TRL of 6, which is a scaled prototype of our system, by 2025. And in doing that, we'll have actively demonstrated the technical feasibility of the system, but also the commercial assumptions that underpin value proposition and the commerciality of the technology.
The battery storage is a fund. It's called the Gore Street Energy Fund. It was the first fund established to develop grid-scale battery storage solutions in the United Kingdom. The UK has one of the highest penetrations of renewables in its electricity system and in its grid. And the strength of renewables is that once you build the infrastructure, solar or wind, it keeps delivering. The weakness is the intermittency that is not always on. And so you need backup systems. And one of the emerging and substantial backup systems is grid-scale battery storage. We now have the biggest grid-scale battery storage operation on the island of Ireland. We are a significant player in the United Kingdom. What does it show? Actual solutions to actual challenges capable of being implemented today with today's technology. The logic of big grid operators is that they understand that they've got a potential hole in the bucket and they need to fill it. And sometimes they need a big spurt of energy for a short period of time. And the battery storage possibility is a real answer to that part of the need. Positive, available, and now.